This is a patient with a diabetic tractional retinal detachment. The patient has central vision, but it's very tubular and progressively getting worse with 4 quadrants tractional retinal detachment. That's the OCT of the patient here. You can see the macula is even endangered. Here's the surgical plan. The area of traction is outlined by the red color, and the aim is to cut into that area and segment, as well as delaminate without creating retinal breaks. If we can dissect the vitreous further out, would be great because the vitreous is very adherent out till the periphery in this case. Here's the start of the surgery with a chandelier in, starting with vitrectomy just to clear some vitreous. Then I go to the disc and start the dissection from in out. Using a forceps here and pulling on the disc just to start the dissection plan, followed by the vitrector to clear some of the vitreous. The use of vitrectomy is very efficient, but the problem is with the vitrector and the retina is detached, there's high risk of creating retinal breaks, so one needs to be very careful. And as you can see here, the vitreous is attached with areas of traction, which I'm trying to relieve, again going from in out. This is a long surgery. It took about 3 hours, and here most of the clips are sped about from two to four times, and of course it's heavily edited. What I've been trying to do in this case is to use instruments, for example the vitrector, then switch to other instruments here, the vertical scissor, to again cut the adhesions and go outside to the periphery, then switch to the horizontal scissor. So I've been trying to be efficient with the use of instruments. Still took a long time. This is the vertical scissor, and you can see the scissors do not cut vitreous very well. Again, continuing with the vertical scissors, that's 23 gauge. I'm getting some success here temporarily. And then switching to bimanual with horizontal scissors. In this part, I switched to the cutter to remove some of the vitreous hemorrhage and also to cut this band. And now back again to the horizontal scissors, working freely. This area initially looked like a break, but it was just an opening in the posterior hyoid. Inferiorly, there was strong adhesions, and you see extensive dissection inferiorly just to be able to relax the retina. Now, a lot of the time is spent in inferiorly to relax the retina. You can see here the vitreous is very adherent and is wrinkling and crunching the retina. So that's where time was spent to relax the vitreous adhesions here. The retina is starting to look better inferiorly. So again, more horizontal scissor delamination. Now back to the vertical scissors, and I realized that it's very difficult to detach the hyaloid inferiorly. I'm going to the periphery, so I'm cutting with the vertical scissors, making cuts there just to try to relax the retina further. And here trimming of the peripheral vitreous that I managed to cut with the cutter. There remains here adherent hyaloid, which I was not able to remove either with the scissors or with the cutter. And because the retina is detached, I decided to leave that. I tried again from posterior to anteriorly with some success to separate a membrane with some of the vitreous, but otherwise it was difficult to remove the peripheral vitreous that I just commented on. Here removing some Kenalogan blood that was previously dissected. I'm finally just finishing the peripheral vitreous, trimming what I've cut. And now here just indentation to look for breaks and some peripheral laser in the very periphery. You want to be cautious here not to do much laser in detached retina because you can pop the retina open. I did not want to completely fill with air because I thought if I go to the disc and drain more, the retina will be displaced. So I only drained enough to just close the ports. This is 1 week after the surgery with the retina much better attached, and this is the OCT.